Well, it's Monday. I haven't done a podcast in 2 weeks. I have done many, but I have trashed them. This is Birdie Lavorne, the Faith Leap Podcast, episode 13. And I'll start off with why I keep trashing these podcasts. And it's because it doesn't feel like it's cohesive. It's just kind of all over the place for the last couple of weeks. And my message that I'm trying to permeate the ether with is one of hoping a spark comes into people that makes them inquisitive and makes them want to, you know, deep dive into the world of esoteric teachings and Gnostic readings. But I don't know, I'm still not versed enough on it to really have the scholarly conversation about it. So I keep trashing them. Maybe I should just put them out there. I don't know. Doesn't feel like I should. So they're gone. Anyhow, today, I want to kind of talk about friendship and go in a little bit deeper on friendships and relationships that we form in our lifetimes. And then my mother always used to tell me, if you die with 5 good friends, you know, one hand, if you can count all of your friends on one hand, you're a lucky soul. And I think that I can definitely do that. I have some very good friends who always seem to have my back. And of course, I would die for them. But recently, I moved into this area. I had no idea what to expect when I moved into this area because it's a very rural area, and I didn't think that I would be able to find people that kind of thought like me or I could carry on conversations that were kind of stimulating to me. I just, you know, I kind of judged it before I got here, thinking that, oh boy, I'm going to go into this rural area and it's a highly Amish and Mennonite and fundamentalist Christian, and I'm not going to be able to relate to any of the people, and my conversations are going to have to be online or, you know, with someone who is in my family that kind of gets me. But much to my surprise, I have built a circle of friends in a very quick time for me. I was always one of those people who kept most people at an arm's length simply because I am an extrovert and an introvert, but I lean more towards introvert. And I have a hard time, it's not trust. It's really, you know, not a trust factor because I've got, you know, skin of Teflon for the most part, and words don't hurt me and drama doesn't affect me. I just kind of, you know, let it in one ear and out the other. Never been one to play with drama. And I've always been one of those people that if I do stumble across a friend and build a friendship, and those people just consume and just pull all of my energy, I generally fire them as a friend. A friendship is one of give and take. A friendship is one of really listening to that person and them listening to you. Unfortunately, there's a lot of people that I've stumbled across that are very one-sided and they never say, hey, how are you doing? So those are no longer really in my circle of friends. I do consider them lovely people, but they're not in my active friend circle. But going back to moving here, I have had I don't like the word amazing. I think it's overused. I have had the profound experience that I have made some friends which kind of feel like lifetimers. The generosity has been just of time, and the generosity has been humbling, to say the least. I have made one friend who is a fundamentalist Christian, but the very first day of our friendship birth, we decided that, you know, I laid my foundation of, you know, kind of my Eastern philosophy leanings, and she laid hers, and we just kind of smiled at each other and decided that that's not somewhere that, you know, we were going to go, for the lack of better term. We were not going to sit there and dwell on each other's differences in philosophies and religions. And our friendship has blossomed and turned into something that's just very beautiful. I looked at her one day and I said, "You're the person I've been waiting for all my life," because she is an artist and she loves to tinker. And I love to tinker with all different mediums. She's just such a beautiful, giving soul. She's a little bit older than me, and she's teaching me so much about art. She is a potter and a painter and just a creative right-brainer. You know, she's just got this. She puts really cute things on her trees because she knows that those are God's work of art, these beautiful, beautiful trees. And it has been a void in my life where I found someone who could really just tinker with me, or that wanted, you know, that lived close enough that we could actually tinker together. So I've spent many hours tinkering in her studio just with metals and with clay and sticks. And we've just had the best time. Big animal lover, so she totally gets that side of me too. And it's a coming together. It feels very warm and very inviting, even though we're kind of different on a lot of other topics. When we're together, we just kind of share, and she teaches and I teach her, and it's a back and forth. Boy, is that so hard to find. I've waited so many years to find someone that I could just kind of not worry about being too far out there, or not feeling like I was going to be judged for seeing faces and, you know, in anything. I kind of like, I've started this Instagram piece where when I'm at the bakery and I see a face in the pan from the butter and the cinnamon roll, I take a picture of it and I kind of make it into a collage. And she kind of gets that. And I can respect that the universe has given me someone in my life that I needed so much. And I've also run across another friend who kind of does think the same way that I think, you know, under a umbrella of philosophy, and really goes way out there. I've only spent time with him a couple of times, this last Saturday being the most time that I've ever spent with him, but we just had really great conversations. Even though we were working, we had really great conversations and enjoyed each other's company and kind of didn't feel like a leper with some of the far out things that we think about. And boy, how lucky am I to have found like these people when I least expected to find those kind of people that, and maybe, you know, maybe it's me. Maybe I've opened myself up some to where I'm not judging anybody else. Maybe that was something that I was doing beforehand, was kind of judging someone who didn't, you know, think like me and pushing them away. I don't know how many missed opportunities I could have had. Maybe I had many. Maybe I had none. I'm just not quite sure on that one. But friendships and relationships I have found to be very essential. And the wisdom, one of my best friends is having trouble with a decade, multi-decade long friend. And it seems like they're coming back together, maybe. But in a friendship, we do change. I mean, every cell in our body changes over a 7-year span. And we change. And our mind changes. And what we have to realize at the very end of this is, even though that person may have changed some or a lot, done a 180, we have to hold in our hearts the love that we have for that person. And that has to supersede everything else. The love that we have for a friend or a relationship, that has to come to the forefront when we feel like we're, you know, being challenged by that friendship or disappointed in that friendship on the way that things turned out. And we've never walked in the shoes of that person. So, you know, if there was turbulent times, we have no idea where their minds were, where their hearts were. And that's for them. That's for them to hold. What we have to do is remain the constant source of compassion, non-judgment, love, and just be very delicate with the way that we handle things. We have to dig deep. Sometimes if we feel like we're being challenged by that person, that is for a purpose, and it's for a purpose of self-growth. So that person, that beautiful soul that's been in our lives so many years, maybe some of the adversary had to come in for us to learn something from it. So I don't know, I say that because I've experienced a little bit in the last year, and I will forever, in the deepest part of my soul, I will forever take a bullet for that person. I may not agree with them, and it may be challenging, but I love them. And that's what we have to remember, is how much love we have for that person that you chose to be in your inner circle. I don't care if it was in 1971 or in 2018. You just love them. Because everything's about love, right? So this is my podcast for today. I hope it inspires you to be gentle with your heart and to be gentle with the other person's heart. Because we're all here having a very human experience. But we are divinity. So, peace and love. Adios, amigos.